money for now.
Farewell.
Hmm? Is it important? Potatoes, garlic, radish. Yeah, that should be it.
Hey, wait a minute, you...
Huh?
Never mind.
What? What is it?
Oh, you're an outlander, aren't you? From Kira.
Yeah.
Your skin, it looks,
darker?
Different.
Potatoes, garlic, radish.
Why do you ask?
I mean no offense, really. I'm just, well, curious.
My mother does, yes. I grew up on Naram, though.
Naram, you say? Huh. But still, your mother must have told you a lot about her homeland, didn't she?
Is it true that a child on Kira has at least 5 fathers and 4 mothers? An old sailor told me that once. You live in those, communes, not in regular families, right?
Do we? Was that true? I'm guessing these are true, what I'm saying. I have no personal knowledge of myself, but... yeah, some people live in those, but not many. You know, Kiranian culture is quite rich. The communes are just a facet.
Oh, yes, of course. There are mage circles, the universities... The sailor told me that, too. You know, once this chaos in the world is over, I want to go travel myself. Who knows? Maybe a captain will hire me as a deckhand. Anyway, thanks for your time. Walk blessed.
Walk blessed to you too.
Oh, you're an outlander, aren't you? From Kira. Your skin, it looks...
Sorry, guys. Naren.
Is it true that a child on Kira has at least 5 fathers? Oh, yes. You know, once this chaos in the world is over, I want to go travel myself. Who knows?
Vexen?
Maybe a captain will hire me as a deckhand.
Anything interesting around here?
Thanks for your time.
Apart from my wares, you mean? Well, jokes aside, no. At the moment, it's quiet around here. Thank Malthus it is. You don't hear a lot of good things from the streets these days. I have to remember. Vatiers, brigands. This country has seen better times.
Some things never change.
All you'll ever need. But please, take a look.
What do you have in stock?
Oh, a lot. Tell me if something catches your eye.
Leucogericus. That caught my eye, but I don't want it. So we got consumables, well, food. Oh, really? You got pretzels? Pretzels? Hell yeah, I'll take a pretzel. Just one. One pretzel. Honey nut bun. Oh, dates.
May your path always be even.
Oh, thank you.
Potato.
You found a secure chest. Items which you place in a secure chest can't be lost or stolen. You can find them in every settlement and near myriad towers, and all of them share the same inventory. Sounds really convenient.
Garlic, radish.
Sure, I'll take advantage of that at some point.
I really need that new herbal essence for my hair.
Now, good part of peace, Wayne. Jesus, why is that stuff so expensive?
Oh, that's that guy got some more normal Malalatata has. Hi. You seem short. You're a hunter, right? How's the situation in the wilderness?
Don't ask. The wolves act as if they've been cursed.
attacking anything and anyone on sight.
Tell me about it.
And killing game they don't even eat afterwards. This must be the red madness everyone's talking about. Oh, blazes. Where's this supposed to lead?
Where's what supposed to lead? I'm new in the area. Do you happen to have any tips for me?
Tips? Just be wary if you're outside city walls. I guess you've noticed as much already, but this country has seen better days.
Hmm. Okay, thank you.
You don't have any business here. Shove off.
Alright. Okay, last warning. Got it. Jeez. Just having a nice conversation. Who puts a bookcase out in the middle of nowhere?
I hope the new turnips come soon.
Tammy? Oh. Didn't mean I had that. Get back here, Tammy.
That should be it. Wow. Nice sword.
Thank you.
Oh shit. I have to remember that.
Tammy!
Hey, you there. You want to know a secret?
Yeah. It's a secret how you run so fast? What kind of secret?
A really great secret, you'll see. If you, give me 30 pennies and I'll tell you.
And what why should I believe that your secret is really worth 30 pennies? I don't have that much money.
Because I promise? Please? With those pennies, I can have Mizir Gatsidona make me a wooden horse like the one Sen has. Please?
Why are you looking at me like that? Oh. She's magical. Well, was she in my head the whole time? Fine, here you go. I'm gonna regret this, aren't I? Now tell me.
Wait. Let me count first. Wow. There really are 30. You're great. Thank you. So, do you know my sir Mitimiel? The, what do you call it? The tanner.
The one at the marketplace, you mean? What about him?
Well, last night I heard these weird noises coming from his house, as if he was building something, so I snuck up to his window. He has this secret stash in his house. I think to open it, you have to pull these hidden levers, but I'm not sure. I don't know. Maybe you... Well, you know. Anyway, I have to go now. Thanks again!
Weird noises... and hidden levers and secret stash. I heard of a dangerous but profitable way to earn money. Ark's Guard searches for bounty hunters who support them by capturing criminals. The bounty missions are posted on notice board in Ark and Riverville. I heard the guards talking about how something bad happened to Matilda and how the mayor doesn't deserve that. I should ask the mayor what happened to her. Ask the mayor about problems of his wife. Celeste showed me a casket which most likely washed up at the beach near Riverville. Instead of the anticipated treasure, there was only a note on it, which greatly disappointed him. There was some sort of poem on it, perhaps some sort of hint? Find the place described there by the poem. He did say it was behind his house. Arcane Fever. Let me check that. How do I... I have forgotten how to do this. Hero menu, H. I could do that, go on an apparition. Here we go. My fear is only at 20%, I'm okay. Hello.
You're not from here, are you? I heard you talk.
Yeah?
Wow, that's nice armor you're wearing there.
Thanks.
One day, I'm gonna be an adventurer. And I'm gonna explore the
Someday,
entire world.
I'll go to Ark.
It'll take a long time.
Everything's supposed to be so huge and shiny there.
Hey, you're an adventurer, aren't you? I bet you've got a lot of stories to tell.
What do you have there?
Potatoes, garlic, radish.
What is that?
That should be it.
You're not smoking a pipe, are you? So I've been here, I think? Yeah, he told me to get the hell out.
I hope the new turnips come soon.
If that's all you're looking forward to, that's pretty sad, mister. Alright, let's check out the mayor's wife.
You're not from Riverville, are you? What do you want?
Feather wall. I heard your wife is sick.
Is that so? What does that have to do with yourself?
Why so distrustful? Maybe I could help you.
How noble of you. But how do I know you're not a quack? I know nothing about you.
Look, I really do understand a thing or two about magic, and maybe I can help your wife. Because I sound a little more confident than I really am.
All right then. I suppose it can't get any worse than it already is. Come, let's go upstairs. Take a seat.
I guess not that one.
Well then, let's keep this short. For 3 moons now, Matilda has been hearing voices. Sometimes during the day, sometimes at night. There is no pattern. According to what she told me when she was still lucid, the voices seem to come from the sea. And it's a mixture of pleading, screams, and weeping.
She's hallucinating.
Maybe so. Or maybe it is some kind of a ghost, or a magical anomaly. Only Malphus knows. Since the night she first heard the voices, however, her health has been worsening. At first she lost her appetite. Then she started vomiting. To make things even worse, she now has a fever that gets more dire by the minute. Father Vildas is clueless, and even the two apothecaries who quickly passed through the village said they don't know what's wrong with her. She has even stopped recognizing me lately, and talking to her has become impossible. I don't want to lie, stranger. I just don't know what to do anymore. If it keeps going like this, Matilda will not see the turn of the year.
Well, it sounds like she doesn't have time to spare for me to get better at magic. I'm really sorry. And do these voices say anything?
No. According to what she said to me when she was still lucid, they are just a babble of voices, and a horrible one at that.
And only she can hear these voices, correct?
Yes. And the times when she hears them are her only waking moments. She then starts screaming. On and on, flailing around as if the Black Guardian stood before her.
Who's that?
It's horrible to see her like that. My brother Meldor is a traveling arcanist, and has already examined the house for magical anomalies. All to no avail. Whatever causes these voices, it only affects her.
Hmm. And you don't have the slightest idea as to where this came from?
No, not in the least. You know, Matilda is such a good person. If it is a ghost that has possessed her, then it must be a cruel one who only wants to see her in pain. And if it's a disease, then Malthus shall be damned for making her suffer like this. I'm sorry. I should not have said that.
Yeah. Anybody can talk about Malthus like that. It's fine. I will see if I can find out what's causing this. Do you have any idea where to start?
You. Maybe it helps if you were there for one of these seizures. I don't feel comfortable about it, but if it could help, we have to give it a try.
That might be a good idea. How should we go about that?
Just come back in a few hours' time. It hasn't been too long since she had the last one. Give me a moment with her until then, all right? My brother Melder will let you in once it's time.
Mm-hmm. Witness the fit. All right. Stand by, guys. Okay. Oh.
Ah, hello. You're the visitor Dugar told me about, right? The Outlander?
That's his name? I am, yes. Are we ready?
Well, as ready as we can be. As Dugar probably told you, the seizures happen arbitrarily, but more often around this time. Come, follow me. While I do appreciate your endeavours, I'm a little sceptical as to what good it will do. Whatever is wrong with Matilda is not ordinary. But I suppose some chance is better than none, isn't it?
This is probably going to be interesting.
You have a visitor, Dugar.
Thank you, Meldor. And thank you for not changing your mind. It could happen any minute. Just take a seat and wait. And I warn you, this is not going to be pleasant. Oh, Matilda.
No, please. No.
Oh, and here we go.
Yoga, they are coming. They are coming back. No, 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 please don't.
Ah! Oh.
There's no other way.
Pentas.
Pentas. I know that name. That farm. That house.
So?
I think I heard something.
You mean you heard the voices? What are you? Some kind of medium?
I've had these visions since recently. It sounds bizarre, I know, and I don't understand it myself. Does the name Pentas mean anything to you?
Pentas? I don't know, but...
That was the fisherman, don't you remember? The one who collaborated with the brigands and was killed when he tried to resist the arrest.
His house is not far from here.
Ah, yes, of course. And his companion drowned herself afterwards. Poor thing. But I don't understand. What? By the righteous path. Does that have to do with Matilda's sickness?
It's a mystery. I don't know. But something tells me that we should follow this lead.
Something tells you this, I see. If the circumstances were any different, I would take you for a quack, trying to win my favor. But you seem honest, and I shouldn't leave anything untested.
Thanks.
Meldor, where was that fisherman's house again?
I have a map.
I know where it is.
Then give it to her.
Of course, brother.
If Pentas really has anything to do with this, you should take a look at his old house. It should be abandoned.
Should be.
And now excuse me, both of you. I need some time for myself.
Pentas is dead? He's busy. Disciplines of Magic, Psionics. Cool. The Holy Order. Is that the book I found? The Holy Order? No, okay. Oh, it's the Golden House. The Path, Tome 3, The Gods. This is awesome. Another copy of the Holy Order. King Lude and the Maidservant Devotia? Awesome. I look forward to reading these. What about these books? Wait. A Book of Poetry. Account of an Unknown Traveler, Volume 1. I'm starting to get almost weighed down here. The Disciplines of Magic Entropy. Well, I can read those. Oh, it's an actual book. Okay, I thought this was... Okay. I thought that was a skill book. Cool. Alright. Look forward to reading those as well. Looks like I have my work cut out for me. Account of an Unknown Traveler, Volume 2. Psionics again. The Path, Tome 12, The Star Summer Night. The Path, Tome 6, The Lost Ones. Guess he really isn't paying attention. Wait. Oh! Hi. Entropy. Same. Let me just look in. Yeah. It's all entropy. Volume 2. Encyclopedia Arcana. Magic. Part 2. Sweet. The Disciplines of Magic, Elementalism. Landscapes of Enderal, Golden Forest. Golden House, I have. The Crystal Jellyfish, Its Physique and Use in Alchemy. Awesome. See this one? Yeah.
Here, this is the map.
Oh.
This house isn't far from the village, but you should be careful nonetheless. I don't need to tell you that the animals have grown savage recently.
Yeah, it came this way.
This red madness,
that way.
Or whatever they call it.
I'm interested in what exactly happened to this Pentas. Could you tell me more about it?
As I said, he was a traitor. He collaborated with the brigands on the Penny Road. He played innocent, but eventually the guards found out and tried to arrest him. Well, as it happened, he tried to play Lorem Waterblade and attacked them, which didn't go well for him. His wife couldn't cope with that, so she took her life. A tragic story, but it was his choice. That's life.
Hmm. So you said you're an arcanist, right? So you are a part of this holy order?
This holy order? By the gods, you really do have Outlander written all over your face.
Thanks.
But no, mm-hmm. I am not. I have, as all the magically gifted have, passed the walk to the water, but I didn't qualify to become a keeper or a magister. And to be honest, I didn't want to either.
Hmm. So you're neither a wild mage nor a keeper. What does that make you?
A free arcanist, as are many others. But with all due respect, I think we should save the talk for later. Matilda's condition gets worse by the minute.
Okay.
Hmm?
Oh, he turns away again. Good. The Path, Tome 3, The Gods. Oh, he's leaving too. Awesome. Okay, volume 2 I have of that. Well, it's all the same. Hello. Well, I can't sell this stuff, can I? If it's stolen. I'll take the arrows, though. More books. The Life of Torgon Whispertongue, Volume 4? Really? A lot of volumes of that? The Path, Tome 7, The Kraken. Well, The Kraken, rather. Encyclopedia Arcana Magic, Part 4. That's the Vin geographical thing. Earnings. I can't actually read that. Golden Force, yeah, I got that one. The Lost Brigand. A lot of these Golden Force books. Crystal jellyfish again. Ooh. Vin. Now, can I read the earnings? I'll help you, and also steal from you blind. What's that statue? That looks pretty cool. Alright, so...
You're not from... are you? I heard you talk.
You heard me talk. I haven't gone up here.
I hope the new turnips come soon.
Riverville Temple. Maybe that shrine is around here somewhere?
My dame.
Farmer.
Beloved children, I am glad to see so many of you have come. It shows me that you have not forgotten that only faith which is practiced is true faith. In tonight's sermon, I want to talk about death.
Just in time,
there is hardly a feeling which wakes similar emotions in us. Why do we have to die? Is death not a punishment? And if so, why does Malthus grant some of us a life full of peace and serenity, while others, equally pathabinding people, have to endure suffering? It seems unjust, yes, and I too oftentimes have asked myself how such inequality can persist under Malthus's watchful eyes.
Well, these aren't letters.
Yet the answer is so near, if only we know where to look. For it is not the lack of answers, but the question itself that is the problem. Let me recite to you a passage from the letters of Father Weidenthal.
Okay, I'll let you.
And so the grieving widow said after her companion's death to Malthus, O Lightborn, why must I suffer such woe? Why must I, until the end of my path, live in grief, while the baker's woman can live happily with her wife? And then a figure made of pure light appeared, so divine and sublime that the widow fell onto her knees, for she realized it was but Malthus himself. Do not grieve for the loss of your man, O lost soul, he said. He was a path-abiding, noble being, and I myself have judged his deeds in his last journey. He is now walking on the eternal path at my side. But despite the musical voice of the light figure, the widow could not find peace. For she remembered all the joy, all the beautiful moments she and her man had been granted together. O Lightborn, I understand that my husband is now at peace, but I shall never see him again.
Sit down.
So why do you punish me with such suffering? Have I not, too, always lived a path-abiding life of worship and faith?
Get out of the way.
Then something incredible happened. The light figure knelt right before the woman, and full of fatherly love caressed her gray hair.
Sit down, lady.
How about that? Another traveler.
Shh.
I thought I was the only one still traveling these lands.
Shut up.
Like a man who, for all his life, saw the world through a tainted window, and just now realized he only had to open the door to walk outside. Your question speaks of great providence, said the Lightborn, full of compassion and dignity. But tell me, what would make your life worth living, were there to be no death? Is it not death itself that gives you the wish to cherish each day?
He's got a
would
point.
Would you not, should eternal life be granted to you, spend every day in pondering? Full of grave thoughts and dullness, for you would know that in 1,000 years you shall still be in this very same place. The light figure rose. Only mortality grants a soul the courage to walk the holy path. And like a wound lets a warrior emerge from battle even stronger, your grief shall help you come forth as a wiser woman. And tenderly it added, this realization was also, O child, why I chose to not limit death in its doing, even for my faithful followers, because only a life with an end is a life worthy of living.
Mm-hmm.
The woman broke into tears as she realized the wisdom within Malthus's words. Uttering words of gratitude, she lowered her head onto the floor, for the words of the Lightborn had helped her not to see her grief as punishment, but as a trial. And when she looked up again, the Lightborn was gone. Ponder on those words, if sadness troubles your thoughts. Only a life with death is worth living, even if its arbitrariness may seem unjust to you. I wish you all a pleasant night. Walk blessed.